Welcome back to the Junk Room, everybody. I'm the Junk Man, and we're back here to talk Star Wars again with you. What are we going to talk about today? 10 things that make me think the Han Solo movie is going to be great. I know all over YouTube and Twitter and Facebook, everyone's talking about how much they don't want a Han Solo movie. No one asked me, but apparently, every website I see, it says nobody wanted this movie. Well, guess what? I wanted it, and I'm sure there's some others out there that wanted it also. So if you're tired of all the Han Solo bashing, you come to the right place, because we're not going to bash Solo. We're excited for it, and we can't wait. And by we, I mean myself.
Man, you are one pathetic loser.
So here's 10 reasons why I think the Han Solo movie is going to kick ass. Number 10, no Jedis, no Sith, no lightsaber. At least that's what I think. Finally, a Star Wars movie with no Jedis. No lightsaber battles. Now, I know Rogue One was very light on lightsabers and the Jedi's and everything, but there were kind of a Jedi influence in there. And, of course, you had Darth Vader with his lightsaber. I'm hoping we don't get any of that in this movie. I want a pure Han Solo Star Wars movie. Now, another thing I would hope to get away from the Empire, but I don't think we will with this Han Solo movie. But we're going to stay away, I believe, from Sith, Jedi, lightsabers, the Force, and all that. I could be wrong again. This is just what I think going in. I'm excited about seeing a movie going a whole different direction than dealing with stuff we've already seen. Number 9. It's freaking Han Solo. Do I need to say more? It's Han Solo. I mean, how could you not want a Han Solo movie? Han Solo is one of the best characters, if not the best character, of the Star Wars movies. At least the original trilogy, right? How could you not want a Han Solo film? So, we've done 9 and 10. Let's go on to number 8. Because it's going to piss off the haters. There's a lot of people out there that want this movie to bomb. They want this movie to fail. And some of them wanted The Last Jedi to fail. There's a lot of people out there that just want to see Disney or Lucasfilm make a bad Star Wars movie. Well, guess what? It's not going to happen with Han Solo, and it didn't happen with The Last Jedi.
Haters going to hate. And ainers going to ain't.
But I love that this movie is going to be great. It's going to kick ass, and it's going to piss off all those people that want it to fail. So that's my number 8 of why Han Solo is going to kick ass. At least I hope it does. Number 7. Well, there's not a number 7. I couldn't think of 10 things. I tried for about 2 hours to come up with 10 reasons why it's going to kick ass, and I stopped at number 9. But I didn't want to do a video of the top 9 reasons. So number 7 is blank. No reason. So let's go on to number 6. We get Chewbacca. Now, we all saw Chewbacca in the original trilogy, but he was more of a sidekick. He really didn't do much, and he hasn't done much at all in The Force Awakens, or really, really didn't do much in The Last Jedi. So I'm hoping we get more Chewbacca in this film than we did in the original trilogies, where he was just a sidekick. I hope I get to see him rip somebody's arms out of the socket. I hope I see him get to kick some ass. I want to fall in love with Chewbacca. I want a Chewbacca movie. There, I said it.
That's not me making that noise. It's the mask.
So I'm hoping number 6, we get a lot more Chewbacca. So what's number 5? Donald Glover. I mean, look at this guy. How can you not love this guy? And he looks like Lando. He looks like a young Lando. I think he's got that charm. And I'll be honest, I haven't seen him in much stuff except I saw one episode of the show, Atlanta, and I saw a little bit of him in the new Spider-Man movie. But I don't know much about him. But everything I've seen, everybody loves this guy. And he looks like he has that charisma that Lando needs.
Hey, Billy. You free tonight?
Works every time.
Let's go. Number 4. The dude playing Han Solo. Now, I was going to say his name, but every time I said it, I kept messing it up, and I had to edit it out. So I'm not even going to try to say his name. You know what I'm talking about. Aaron Alden, right? Alan Alden, something like that. And I know what you're thinking. What, this guy needs an acting coach? That's what I read on a Star Wars website. No, yes, that's right. He needs an acting coach, not an acting teacher. A lot of Academy Award winning actors use a coach. It's just, a director can't work with an actor all the time, 24/7. The actor coach is going to come in, and they're going to work together to kind of get that Harrison Ford style that the Han Solo needs. Nothing wrong at all with having an acting coach. Again, it's not like a teacher. Athletes use coaches and trainers. It's no different for an actor. And if you're saying, well, this guy can't act, then you've never seen him act before. Now, granted, I've only seen him a couple times, but what I saw him the most in was Hail Caesar. And boy, did I hate that movie. And I'm a big Coen Brothers fan, but that movie was boring as shit.
Boring!
But you know who stole the movie? Han Solo Kid. Whatever, however you pronounce his name. Even critics that didn't like Hail Caesar, almost all of them, commented about how he stole the movie. And he stole the movie from top name actors like George Clooney and... forget the guy's name. The guy from No Country for Old Men. The guy from The Goonies. Can't believe I forgot his name. But there's a lot of big cast in this movie. And Alan Arkin, whatever his name is, stole the... I'll just call him Han Solo. Han Solo stole the movie from these guys, although the movie wasn't too good.
Herbie Doyle cannot act.
Huh. Well, then it were so simple.
Cut. Number three, Ron Howard. Come on, who doesn't like Ron Howard? He directed Willow, Backdraft. He's in a lot of great movies. Now, I know what you're saying. You're saying, Junkman, this guy hasn't directed a great movie in a long time. And I'll give you that. He hasn't had a great movie in a long time. But I think that's because he's picked bad script. I don't think anything he's done has been badly directed. I think he just hadn't had the opportunity, or maybe he's not good at picking script. I don't know why he's done some of the recent stuff he's done. But we know that he can direct his ass off. He's a great director, and hoping this was going to bring him back to something. I mean, Apollo 13, Cocoon. I could go on and on about everything he's done. I'm so happy to have Ron Howard on this film. Number two, Academy Award-winning Lawrence Kasdan. That's who's writing this film. And you're saying, who is that? Well, let's see. He's the guy that wrote The Empire Strikes Back. He wrote The Big Chill. He wrote a movie called Raiders of the Lost Ark. This guy knows how to write movies. And best of all, he knows how to write Han Solo. He loves Han Solo. He created Han Solo probably more than George Lucas did. Everything that we fell in love with Han Solo and The Empire Strikes Back is because of this man, Lawrence Kasdan. And you say, why did we do a Han Solo movie? Who wants a Han Solo movie? Well, this guy does. He wanted to make a Han Solo movie. And I don't know if this is fact from the rumors I've heard online. He got this Han Solo deal when he agreed to do The Force Awakens. He loves Han Solo, and no one out there can write Han Solo as good as Lawrence Kasdan. Again, he wrote The Empire Strikes Back. What more do you need? And now, the number one reason why the Han Solo movie's gonna kick ass. Kathleen Kennedy. Has she done a bad Star Wars movie under the whole new Lucas-Disney regime? No, she hasn't. Is she gonna do a bad one with Solo? No, she's not. And how do I know this? Well, Kathleen Kennedy fired Lord & Miller. Now, I'm not saying nothing about Lord & Miller. I like their Lego movie. I hadn't seen their other 21 Jump Street and all their other stuff. And they seem like really decent guys. But what Kathleen Kennedy did is she watched the dailies or watched what they filmed, didn't like what she saw. And what would most studios do? They wouldn't want to go over budget. They would just finish the movie as is, try to fix it in editing, and release it out in the public and not really give a shit. We've seen it happen a lot. But what does Kathleen Kennedy do when the Solo movie isn't on par? She fired them when they were almost done filming the thing and brought in Academy Award winning director Ron Howard. Now, I know a lot of you got a lot of bad things to say about Kathleen Kennedy. I don't understand why. She did. I mean, look at everything she's produced. Be here all day trying to read all this. The Force Awakens, great. The Last Jedi, great. Rogue One, I really like Rogue One. I'm not in love with it like I am The Force Awakens or Last Jedi, but it's really good. And now she's going to do Solo. Kathleen Kennedy, thank you.
I don't know where you get your delusions, laser brain.
Well, that's 10 reasons right there why I think the Han Solo movie is going to kick ass. Please, let me know in the comments what you think. I'm sure I'm going to get some of those fire Kathleen Kennedy comments or... Who asked for this Han Solo movie? Nobody asked for this Han Solo movie. Well, guess what? I fucking asked for it. I don't remember them saying we only can make movies that people ask for. And who's this asking? I didn't take a poll. Did you take a poll? No. Stop saying no one asked for this Han Solo movie. Because again, I asked for it. I wanted to see it. I talk to people on Twitter all the time that want to see it. And you know who wanted to see it? You know who wanted a Han Solo movie more than anybody? Lawrence Kasdan. He is Han Solo. He knows Han Solo better than anybody. How can you say no to Lawrence Kasdan? So please stop saying nobody wanted this movie. Because yes, maybe it wasn't as big as people want the Obi-Wan Kenobi movie. Or people want the a Boba Fett movie, maybe. But I bet there's more people out there that was wanting a Han Solo movie over a Rogue One movie. Now, I'll be honest, I wanted a Rogue One more. Han Solo wasn't my top pick. If you gave me a list of five characters for a Star Wars movie, Han Solo would have been in that top five. Now, there are some few things that I hope they don't do, which, from everything I'm reading, they're gonna do. I didn't want a Han Solo origin story. I wanted the film just to kind of pick up, show a Han Solo and maybe a Lando adventure together, give us no real backstory to him. Kind of keep him a mystery. I didn't care about how he got the Falcon. I didn't want to see him do the castle run. I didn't want to see him rescue Chewbacca. I don't want to see him get a scar on his face. But I'm afraid we're going to get some of this in this movie. I'm not sure about Chewbacca. Hopefully he's already with Han when we meet up with him. But I'm pretty sure we're going to get how he gets the Falcon from Lando. The castle runs. 100% sure we're going to get that. So hopefully we'll just get a few of that origin stuff. It won't be all about it. I hope we don't turn into the Last Crusade situation. The Last Crusade, in the first 10 minutes, we got how Indiana Jones got his style, how Indiana Jones got to use a whip, how Indiana Jones was scared of snakes, how Indiana Jones got the scar on his face. We got everything we ever wondered about Indiana Jones. All happened to him within 5 minutes. So I hope that doesn't happen in Han Solo. Again, I hope we get some mystery still. I hope it's not a full-out origin story. I don't want to see him as a kid. I don't want to jump around in time. I hope I just get an adventure with Lando, Han, Chewbacca, and a lot of new characters. But I ran it enough. Now will somebody give me a damn trailer?